Not all dice are created equal. So what I'm going to be doing in this video is just doing a quick way to check how fair these $1 dice are off eBay, which can be a good thing to do if you're wanting to create a wallet that is very secure. So there's really nothing magical or technical about what we're going to do here. It's really just going to be about shaking these dice about 100 times, noting down the outcome each time, and then testing that against what we would expect to see if the dice were truly random. And as always, if you'd like to hear more about how to stay safe in the crypto space and how to recover if you get into trouble, just hit subscribe. So as in the previous videos, just to be consistent, I've got my dice in a plastic takeaway container. Basically, there's 10 of them in there. They're a dollar off eBay. The process is to shake the box like that and read from left to right, exactly as they fall in the corner. I'm going to do this 100 times. And just because I love graphs, and I know you do too, we're going to have a graph that updates as we go so I can see the result rather than having to wait until the very end. Okay, we've got a pretty graph. Let's roll some dice. So as we can see from this graph here, these dice aren't perfectly fair. It's not too bad for $1 dice and indicates that there isn't a huge bias where every single one of these dice individually isn't strongly biased towards or away from a particular number. And frankly, I don't actually think it's worth testing each dice individually. Doing 10 of them together as a unit in here actually does increase your security just because even the order in which I read the dice will be changing every time in terms of which dice falls where in the sequence of 10. As we increase the number of counts, it's actually not obvious from a small number of rolls just what the bias actually is. Early in the piece, it would look very different to how this graph works now. And ideally, you would roll this enough times to be satisfied that there isn't a really strong bias towards or away from certain numbers. So if you're worried that your dice aren't perfectly fair, you can always do extra rolls above what is necessary. And if you're using a tool like Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool, it will take all of that entropy together and use it to generate your seed. If you're generating a 24-word seed versus a 12-word seed, you also already have a massive amount of extra entropy just baked into your seed based on the pure number of random events that are part of your entropy already. So I'm really impressed with how these $1 dice went, and to be honest, I'm really not convinced that expensive dice would really be much better at all. But definitely if you're concerned and want to be really thorough about making sure that you're operating in a completely zero trust environment, verify how fair your dice actually are. Thanks for watching, I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.